The last speaker is Ms. Patty Hoppe. I was right once. Welcome, thank you.
Well, I feel very old. That child was in my second grade classroom.
You did a fine job.
Very proud. My name is Patty Hoppe, and I'm here tonight to voice my support to put forth the mill levy override to the voters in Greeley. As you are about to hear, my family and I have a vested interest in Greeley School District 6. First of all, my son Adam graduated from Greeley Central High School in 2011 and immediately joined the United States Army. Because of the guidance of the school counselors and teachers at Greeley Central, he was able to graduate early and begin his military journey. Many more counselors are needed to help high schoolers plan their future while in high school. My daughter Emma will be a senior this upcoming school year at Greeley Central and plans on attending Colorado Mountain College a year from now. As for me personally, I had the privilege of being a teacher at Montford Elementary. I was mentored by Dr. Amy Siminski and then became an instructional coach at Dos Rios. In 2008, I was part of the very first partnership between the district and the University of Northern Colorado in preparing educators to become administrators. I became the assistant principal at Madison Elementary School for 2 years, and now I am the principal of Resurrection Christian School in Loveland, which is the largest private school in Northern Colorado. My husband, Bruce Hoppe, is one of the pastors of Christ Community Church here in Greeley. Christ Community has a strong relationship with District 6 by serving the students at Maplewood Elementary, with mentoring those students and supporting the staff, and also by providing parenting classes with the support of Dr. Mark Thompson. Christ Community also serves a weekly hot lunch to Greeley Central students at our church campus on 15th Street. Another way that the church serves the Greeley community, including District 6 schools, is by holding a yearly Share Fest, where members of Christ Community help improve District 6 schools by weeding, painting, and doing general outdoor facility improvements. We have a vested interest in the District 6 community at Christ Community Church. Finally, my family will be having a former District 6 student live with us so that she is able to attend Greeley Central High School for her senior year. She will be able to participate in the many opportunities that she would not have in China, where she has been currently living for the last 3 years. This student who I speak of, Zoe, was in my second grade class when I taught at Montford. She became friends with my daughter, has been living in China, and now we have taken on guardianship of her so that she will be able to be part of Greeley District 6 for her very important senior year. So as you've heard, my family and I have a huge connection to this wonderful school district. We are committed to helping pursue the passing of the mill levy override because we care deeply for the students and staff who selflessly serve our children. It is my hope and prayer that you approve going forward with putting the mill levy override on the voters' ballot so that students are better served. After all, those students are the most important reason we all should continue to provide the best education and opportunities as possible for them.
Thank you very much. We do have one last speaker, Mr. Randy Watkins. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. I'm actually glad that I didn't have to follow that young man because he was I'm Randy Watkins. Thank you, Dr. Pilch, and members of the board for allowing me the opportunity to speak tonight. My wife and I are actually both natives of Greeley and both products of School District 6, and I'm pretty proud of how we've turned out. Together with my wife, we actually own a number of businesses in town and also recognize that this will be a fairly significant burden on businesses, but I can think of no better investment of our resources than in the education of our children. It was mentioned before, it definitely, it helps us as business owners in attracting and retaining top talent, bringing them to our communities and being able to offer them a great educational system. One of the things that I'm really encouraged about, I'm glad that out of all of the community input, I'm really encouraged by the data that's coming out of the use of technology and the blended learning, and I'm excited that that is part of the initiative. I have the opportunity to do presentations in front of hundreds of professionals, and a few weeks ago I had the opportunity to participate in Junior Achievement for a day. And I was far more intimidated by those fourth graders than I am by those professionals. So I'm also very glad that attracting teachers is part of the Mill Levy Override. So I am here in support of the Mill Levy Override. I also will be out there knocking on doors, and I think it's a great thing for our community. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I feel very excited about all these comments, and I certainly want to thank you all for coming this evening and for sharing with us. We'll be chatting about that decision here fairly shortly. Work session report is next. Ms. Brea?
Board of Education President Roger DeWitt began the work session with open comments from board members and reviewed upcoming calendar events. Kaplan and Ernest representatives Jim Branham and Kristen Edgar discussed the proposed ballot resolution and the provisions of the Fair Campaign Practices Act. Board members had time for questions. Director of Student Life, Bob Billings, gave a presentation on student attendance and behavior. Mr. Billings gave an overview of attendance rates for District 6, which are stable and are the highest overall when compared to several comparable surrounding districts. He reviewed truancy data, intervention levels, and demographic data for affected students. He discussed student discipline data, which shows stable rates for in-school and out-of-school suspensions and expulsions as compared to comparable surrounding districts. Chief Academic Officer Dr. Stacy Dattery presented an update on the district schools that are on turnaround and priority status. She reviewed the goals and action steps for these schools. Board members had the opportunity to ask questions regarding the district budget to Chief Financial Officer Megan Sponsler, and that concluded the work session.
Thank you very much. The next item on the agenda is the superintendent's report. Dr. Pilch, it's tough to follow such an evening.
It is, Mr. DeWitt, and so I'm not going to say much. We have a full meeting ahead of us yet this evening, and lots of community members waiting to be recognized who are committed volunteers at our schools and our business partners. So I just want to say thank you to all of you who came out tonight to speak on behalf of both issues that you spoke about tonight. It is so important that we have an engaged, informed, committed community. And so I thank you for giving up your evening and coming tonight to share your thoughts and opinions with us. Thank you for that. Mr. DeWitt, I'm going to pass it back to you so we can get on to this community recognition part of our board meeting.
Very nice. Thank you very much. It's a lot of going on tonight. The next item then, thank you, Dr. Pilch, is the approval of the agenda, and I know there is a request to amend the agenda, so would, Mr. Hall, are you interested in amending that agenda?
Sure.
All right, sir.
Is that the consent agenda? Or? Oh.
No, it's actually the agenda item. Yeah, thank you, Doug.
Yes, I would move that we amend the agenda as follows by moving item number 7. To the lead position, to the number 1, and then just let the rest of the agenda flow after that.
And did you also want to make an adjustment on the solar? Is that the number 7?
Oh, no. Number 7 was...
I'm doing your work, too.
I'm sorry. The number 7 was for the discussion and adoption of the mill levy ballot so that the people that have been here can have a chance to be around for our discussion. And the second one was to table the solar, which is
J1
to the next meeting.
And again, your proposal is just changing the order of item number 7 to what location?
Number 1.
And then just to which number 1 are you looking at? I'm sorry, I go by letters and numbers.
G1.
One. Oh, okay.
G1.
It won't be too long.
I second it.
It's been moved and seconded. Comments, questions, discussion? Roll call, Ms. Brea, on the amendment.
Mr. DeWitt?
Aye.
Mr. Hayfley?
Aye.
Mr. Hall?
Aye.
Mr. Lydiak?
Aye.
Ms. Pappas?
Aye.
Dr. Richard?
Aye.
Mrs. Solis?
Aye.
And the motion carries, 7-0.
And now I'll ask for the approval of the amended agenda.
I move that the Board of Education of Weld County School District 6 approve the amended agenda as presented.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Comments? Roll call, Ms. Brea?
Mr. DeWitt?
Aye.
Mr. Hayfley?
Aye.
Mr. Hall?
Aye.
Mr. Lydiak?
Aye.
Ms. Pappas?
Aye.
Dr. Richard?
Aye.
Mrs. Solis?
Aye.
And the motion carries, 7-0.
Thank you all very much. Community partners, we're not going to be forgetting you. We're just going to let you, you know, enjoy the environment just a little bit longer.
Hang in there.
But the reward's on its way, we assure you. Going with the suggested change in our order, I now refer you to item number 7, the adoption of mill levy and ballot language resolution. And I'll require a little bit of reading from one of our board members as part of this action item, a motion and an explanation. Mr. Hayfley?
Mill levy and ballot language resolution. Whereas the Weld County School District 6 in the County of Weld in the state of Colorado is a public corporation duly organized, existing under the Constitution and the laws of the state of Colorado, and whereas the members of the Board of Education of the district, the board, have been duly elected, chosen, and qualified, and whereas Article 10, Section 20 of the Colorado Constitution, Tabor, requires voter approval for any new tax, the creation of any debt, and for spending certain monies above limits established by Tabor, and whereas the board has determined that the interest of the district and the public interest and necessity demand and require the district seek voter approval for tax increase for district purposes as described in Section 4 below to provide additional funds for the district's general operating expenses pursuant to Section 22-54-108 CRS, and whereas the board has determined the total additional local property tax revenues generated by the tax increase does not exceed 25% of the district's total program in compliance with Section 22-54-108, CRS, and whereas Tabor requires the district to submit ballot issues as defined in Tabor to districts' electors or limited election days before action can be taken on such ballot issues, and whereas November 8, 2016 is one of the election dates at which ballot issues may be submitted to the eligible electors of the district pursuant to Tabor, and whereas the county clerk and recorder, the county clerk in Weld County, the county will conduct the election on November 8, 2016 as coordinated election, and whereas it is necessary to submit to the eligible electors of the district at the election the proposition of increasing district taxes in excess to the district's total program funding as determined pursuant to the School Finance Act, Title 22, Article 54, Part 1, CRS, and now, therefore, be it resolved by the Board of Education of Weld County School District 6 in the County of Weld in the state of Colorado. Section 1, all action hereof taken not consistent with the provisions of this resolution by the district and the officers thereof directed towards the election and the objects and purposes herein stated are ratified, approved, and confirmed unless otherwise defined herein. All terms used herein shall have the meanings specified in Section 1-1-104 CRS. Section 2, the election shall be conducted as coordinated election in the county pursuant to Tabor, Article 54 of Title 22 CRS, and the Uniform Election Code of 1992, and all laws amendatory, therefore of supplemental thereto, the district hereby determines that the election shall be held on November 8, 2016, and that there shall be submitted to the eligible electors of the district the questions set forth herein. Because the election will be held as part of the coordinated election, the board hereby determines that the county clerk shall conduct the election on behalf of the district pursuant to the Uniform Election Code of 1992. Section 3, the board hereby authorizes and directs the officers of the district to certify to the county clerk on or before September 9, 2016, the following question in substantially the form here in after set forth. Such questions shall be submitted to the eligible electors of the district at the election. 2016 mill levy override question, ballot issue number, shall Weld County School District 6 taxes be increased by $12 million in 2016 for collection in 2017 and by such amounts generated annually thereafter through 2022 for collection in 2023 by a mill levy of up to 10.34 mills to be deposited in the general fund of the district and expended for the educational purposes, which include improving safety, security, and transportation, supporting academic and vocational programs to graduate career-ready students, providing up-to-date instructional materials and technology to support every learner, attracting and maintaining a competitive workforce, allocating mill levy override revenues based on student count to district charter schools authorized as of July 1st, 2016, responding to state funding cuts as necessary, and shall such tax increase be an additional property tax mill levy in excess of the levy authorized for the district's general fund pursuant to and in accordance with this section 22-54-108 CRS, and shall the district be authorized to collect, retain, and spend all revenues from such taxes and the earnings from the investment of such revenues as a voter-approved revenue change and an exemption to the limits that would otherwise apply under Article 10, Section 20 of the Colorado Constitution. Section 4, if a majority of the votes cast on the question to authorize the levy and ad valorem property taxes submitted at the election shall be in favor of levying ad valorem property taxes as provided in such question, the district acting through the board shall be authorized to proceed with the necessary action to levy ad valorem property taxes in accordance with such question. Any authority to levy ad valorem property taxes, if conferred by the results of the election, shall be deemed and considered a continuing authority to levy the ad valorem taxes so authorized at any one time or from time to time, and neither the partial exercise of the authority so confirmed nor any lapse of time shall be considered as exhausting or limiting the full authority so conferred. Section 5, pursuant to Section 1-11-203.5 CRS, any election contest arising out of ballot issue or ballot question election concerning the order of the ballot or the form or content of the ballot title shall be commenced by petition filed with the proper court within 5 days after the title of the ballot issue or ballot question is set. Section 6, the officers of the district are authorized and directed to take all action necessary to appropriate to effectuate the provisions of this resolution. Section 7, all orders, bylaws, and resolutions or parts thereof in conflict with this resolution are hereby repealed. Section 8, if any section, paragraph, clause, or provision of this resolution shall for any reason be held to be invalid or unenforceable, the invalidity or enforceability of such section, paragraph, clause, or provision shall not affect any of the remaining provisions of this resolution. Adopted and approved this June 13, 2016. President, Weld County School District 6. Attest, Secretary, Weld County School District 6.
President DeWitt, I would move that the Board of Education of Weld County School District 6 adopt the resolution for the mill levy and ballot language as just read.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded, and well read, I might add, that the board consider this particular item. Let's hear some comments from board members at this time. We've worked on this for a long time. Ms. Elise?
So I am a product of the school district. My kiddos are products of the school district, and I no longer have kids in the district. But as a community member, as a mom, I can see no other positive thing that we can do as a community but to put this forth and to tell our community and our kids that we believe in them and we're going to support them. So I know that there might be some people out there that are going to say, I don't have kids in the district, but these are the kiddos that are going to take care of us when we're old. These are going to be the kiddos that are future teachers of our grandkids. These are our future, and we must invest in them. So I will be voting yes.
Thank you, Ms. Elise.